All right, let's talk about the Nigeria Women's League, CC.
Yeah, definitely. Rivers Angels are champions.
Yeah, interesting.
But Babafemeji actually wanted Bayelsa Queens for a change. By the end of the day, Rivers Angels didn't know how to do it. You know, check when the last game they played, Lovett Ayila, you know, got that winning goal. And, of course, they got to the final. Hmm. And another Super Falcons player, Osinachi Ogale, also got the first of goal. And that was just enough for them to seal the title. I think I love the way they actually, you know, came out and they told themselves, look, we're going for the title. We don't have to score so many goals. All you need to do, score your goals, lock up and see how you can do that. And of course, they finally did it for them, a sixth title, you know, talking about the Nigerians Women's League. And of course, they've won the FA Cup also six times. And for John, for Edin Okun, he says it's been hard work, dedication, discipline, and of course, prayers. That's what actually has been seeing them through. And he says he wants to maintain a kind of momentum whereby there was so much win the league that other teams will just be, you know, fighting, you know, to get to where they are. They have the third place result. Nasarawa Amazons, of course, Delta Queens, 2-1. Nasarawa Amazons, of course, were finishing third. So Delta Queens, nothing for them at all this season. And another team for the Champions of Pro League clash, it was Abia Angels, who overpowered Tucker Squeeze 3-1 to emerge the best Pro League side of the 2014-2015 season. So for them, they are now in the Nigerian Women's Professional League. So it was really a good one for them because they hosted, so they needed something, you know, to boost their confidence. And of course, they were able to get that. So for them right now, next season, you'll definitely be seeing them playing in the Professional League. So no longer a Pro League side.
Yeah,
I think that's a fantastic,
yeah, fantastic one for the team right there. But I want to go back to Rivers Angels. And yeah, but first of all, I have to give credit to Bayelsa Queens for really, for running them really close this time around. Just the 1-0 victory for Rivers Angels. But then I want to say the other teams really, they really need to step their game up because it gets boring when a team, when you predict at the start of the season that Rivers Angels will win the league and it turns out to be that way, it gets boring. It's no longer a competition. And I wonder what the other teams are really going to do to really, you know, challenge the dominance
of Rivers
Angels.
Maybe they should take some kind of lessons from Rivers Angels. You know,
kind of lessons?
How do you guys do it? That is if Rivers Angels is willing to, you know, let them into their secret.
Yeah, there was a time Pelicans was and
Sister, maybe you can tell us. I don't know if they've
got any secrets. You know, there are things you use in managing clubs. The things that comes into it now, finance, for instance.
That's where I was going.
That's the big one. You know, when you don't, when the money is actually not coming in, it's difficult. Now, Pelican Stars, who were thinking, I mean, they've been very, very competitive. There was a time they were winning the league like five times in a row, you know, back to back and all that. They were really dominant. But it came to a time whereby the finance was no longer there. For them to even host matches at home was even difficult for them. Now, when you're not putting in money into a particular team, the best players will start leaving. You won't get the best coach. Now, check Rivers Angels. Most of the Super Falcons players are from there. No, most of them have actually, you know, traveled out of the country, you know, going to Europe and all that. But you see how others also coming up. We're joking this morning that they were just scoring one goal and all that because their strikers, the likes of Asisat Oshola and all the likes, they've actually, you know, left the club. But you still have Lovett Ayila, you know, who will step up. Osinachi Ogale also step up. And of course, all of them just want to play and, you know, get the results required. So all they need to do, see how you can, you know, put in money into it, get the best players to play, get the very best coach. Of course, you get something out of it.
Yeah, Sissy, I agree with what you're saying. But the issue of funding is a major handicap for Nigeria's women's football in general. Almost all the teams really finding hard and prosecuting the games and all. But then I think it's safe to say Rivers Angels, they have just enough to attract the very best players in the league. And that's why they've really dominated the league for a long time now. So it's up to the other sides and to do what they have to do, you know, to compete.
Yeah, definitely. I love this celebration, you know, after winning the title. They actually expected it and they planned it. And of course, it all worked out so well for all of them. They are the champions right now. So Rivers Angels, of course, congratulations to you girls.
To them.
And hopefully you get to win it again and again. I'm just saying.
All right. For the sake of competition, I want another team to win next year.
That's why some people were actually tipping Bayelsa Queens to do that.
Okay.
the Golden Eaglets, of course, that's next for us on the program tile.
High-flying Golden Eaglets.
Oh, incredible. I don't know if you stayed up to watch the game.
I knew they would get the job done. I don't know where that belief came from, but I knew they would definitely get the job done.
So, in essence, you were very confident and you just went to bed.
At least up to the semi-final point. But now, the final, a North African decider, I don't know. Anything can happen.
It's time to go for a quick break now and let Nigerians get to see how the Golden Eaglets actually did it against
Mexico.
4-2, it ended. Very explosive and semi-finals match. A lot of goals, very poor defending. But then we get to see how it was done and join us again.
High-flying Golden Eaglets getting the job done over Mexico 4-2. And we are delighted they are in a final. Of course, we're also delighted that we have a guest in the house on the show today to take us through what happened right there in the semi-final. He's a well-known face. He's already a friend of the house, if you ask me. We're always delighted to have him on the show. I'm getting lost for words now. I don't know why, but it's
are
interesting.
Are you blushing?
Maybe I am. All right. Onduka Ugbali joins us right now on the show to talk the Golden Eaglets, and we're delighted to have him. Great to be here. Great for you to be
it's
here.
It's my pleasure, Ayo. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Quite interesting that we're all rejoicing and with a little, Cecilia with a little anxiety as well, anxious to see what might likely happen in the finals.